Hello ladies and gentlemen, in this video I will show you the feeling of beginner level programming. Let's start. Let's create a new class. Class. In this video I will make a simple particle simulator. Let's name it Particle Engine. Good. Now let's key listener, maybe no mouse listener, good. Those are enough. Also let's make it geoframe. So we geo panel. So we can turn it into a what's it's called? Application, computer application, desktop. So that should be enough. Particle engine. Yes. Also, I noticed that starting a new project or class in Java is like creating a new world in Minecraft. That way it feels so good. Now I need to bring some vector. I already made a vector type in Helot in this sources. Let's go to Helot 1, game 0. No, the engine, I need to go to the engine. Let's find the vector. Yes, that's our target. Also, there is those things. This handles the part to draw the vector. For now, let's comment all those lines. Simply, this vector is a vector of two floats. You can see it has constructors and getAmplitude function, which returns the square root of, I mean, you know, the vectors, setAmplitude, which sets the amplitude, and disAmplitude, which sets its amplitude to 1. We have minus, which only returns a minus of the vector. And the 1 over, which returns the vectors 1 over version, this thing, you know. Mirrors relative to a point, or get symmetry of the point. Mirrored makes the same thing but returns a new vector instead of doing updating the thing on the current vector. And distance to returns distance between one other point. There is copy functions, copies data from these resources and increase some width, amplify, multiply, increases the current vector's values. Some width returns a new vector with some of the current and other vector's values. Amplify amplifies the current vector with other vector, and the multiply returns a new vector with current and other vectors positions, I mean values. Also, I made these functions for non-vector two floats and single floats. That's all. Vec2i is just int version of vec2f. I mean, actually it has nothing, only two ints. It is just for drawing purposes. So that's all with the vec2f. I want to name it to point2f because it's for me not a complete vector. Let's refactor, name it point. Where's my cursor right now? Good. Where? It gave an error, let's retry. Why it gets stuck that much, I don't know. Maybe OBC uses too much computer power. Good. So its name is point2f, and let's rename this to point2i, rename. Good. So let's create the zoom ratio in here, I guess. Here is a good place. Public. Double float. Zoom ratio 1.f. And this is point2f. Let's rename those. Simply, this function maps the point from screen to engine's map. For doing this, it firstly removes the width and height from the point, then amplifies it relative to zoom ratio. That should be enough. Let's make this two. Firstly, we will not decrease the player position because we do not have player in here. This is multiply because we need a new object code. So that should be enough. Point. Alright. Now we want to make a particle engine. For making a particle engine, we need to create the particle class. Let's create it. public static class particles it has a public and let's name it position velocity forces or right let's name it acceleration good and that should be enough back posit points public point 12 now let's public float mass and collision radius but we should name the radius rads radius by default let's make it 20.f good so before then making a particle we need to make an actual application right so let's get in the actual application part public static class application window extends geoframe also let's make the generated serial version for this tool good so public particle engine let's name it my engine in here we need to also make a constructor for this object let's say super dot default set default close operation exit on close good super set position anyways I guess there is not such function in here component main gene code super dot add mouse listener this is Mangino and let's carry this code to Mangin's constructor public particle set super dot set visible. True. Good. Super dot add key listener managing. Good. Super dot set preferred size new dimension, and let's create the dimensions. Public int with width is 80 by default, let's say. Let's write the V before both of them, so we are sure this is window width. Also, I do not know how we write the width. Let's write the get width function. Good. Super dot set I guess I forgot something important. Let's find it. Initialize location relative to null. Good. This should be enough. Now only thing we need to do is public static void main. Engine equals new partic and only thing I need to do is creating one application now. Let's try to run this thing. Yes, it runs. Let's try this. Good. Application window is being created successfully. Now let's carry this part from here to alt button, because we might want to use this part once again for a long time. Good. So we created the application. Now we need to override the paint component method of this gpanel. Public void. Also, I need to write here override. Good. Now let's don't you forget that you can press Ctrl, Shift, and O to automatically import the libraries, I mean modules in Eclipse. So we will start by let's make a public color. And let's make it a really like dark face of gray, like 31 31 31. Target.set background color BGC. Good. Now let's target dot clear rect 0 0. Also let's set the width and height functions at the beginning of the code. So we can easily adapt the changes in our application. Let's try it. Good, our application is gray right now. Where did the Eclipse go? Good. So we have a particle class that should be handled. Next thing we need to do is handling these particles. For handling these particles, let's make a constructor, public particle vec 12. position, position, velocity. This is point, I always forget this point. Equals new velocity. Also, we already made a half hour sequence of coding. New code. Reduce by default 20. So let's make the draw to function public. Draw to 2D target. Let's name it draw data. And target for making this, I guess I should make a function. I mean point to I. Also, I need to turn this into a I'm trying to understand the error. I guess we need to inherit, write the particle engine here, in here. Let's copy it. Owner. Those stupid errors, my boy, it is really annoying. I see. I guess I need to make a function for converting this to a vector I. Let's cast both of those to int. So we achieve the position, right? Also, we have the radius. Hello. So let's draw the target to draw a circle. Although we draw a circle, I forgot, I guess. Draw oval, yes. Posi. Width and height. So this is 2 times radius, right? So let's turn it to int. And target dot how do we draw a point? Is there a point? So let's draw a simple small rect here in the middle. Fill rect. Pause. Minus 2 So let's create a particle. Public particle. Those will be points. Good, let's try. I forgot that we need to decrease the reds from posi. Let's name this the pose, drawing position. Good. I guess I forgot to mirror this. This function is not enough because we need to also mirror So firstly, while mapping map to S or mapping from screen to engines map, we need to decrease the toes position. Then relative to zoom ratio, we need to amplify it, right? Yes. Then we need to reverse the Y, because Y is in reverse. So while we are doing the exact opposite, firstly we need to actually changing the order of zoom ratio doesn't matter. This can start stay in the middle at first line. Let's try this now. So let's make the log function in here so we can log things easier. Good. For now we are mapping from screen to, map to screen. So let's see the data that came along with us. Good. We also need to make a pass. Name it input. Y in mirror. To middle, let's see. I don't have a string to string operator override for this function, this class. Let's make one. Good. Now let's try to repaint. Let's try to paint. mirror works good. So if we repaint it while it's like that, we cannot even see it, but it always keeps in the middle, in the x coordinate, and goes upward relative to x coordinate. Why? Did I write here get width? Really? Get height. What if I remove this part and let's retry? I guess it's the trouble is in the draw data. Yes, this is X. It's kind of correct. Let's shrink it in this direction and shrink it in this direction. It's in the middle, good. So the square doesn't look in the middle still. Let's make it 3x3. This is good enough. What if we use only one dot for this object? It's so small. Void draw ball and same things. Go in here. Let's make a float for this purpose. six.f. Let's use the draw valve button tool. I mean code. Particle val color equals. Let's make it reddish. Good. This will be fill oval. And this should be handled before than this. Why the ball is drawn like that? Let's make it 20 if it's related to circle function. I guess the fill oval function works slightly different. That's why it makes this quietly stupider shape. Slightly stupider shape. Let's increase it by 1. 2. That one looks better. This one looks quite good. Not perfect, but quite good. Alright, we already completed one hour. Let's crop this. I am going to end this video in here. In the next video, I already handled these functions. In the next video, I will handle the velocity, acceleration, position, mass, and radius to make collisions among these particles and make them move. Also, I will make a border to keep this particle inside. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.